The thing about Rage is that while it's an incredibly fun game to play, it's severely lacking in other important aspects. Gamers now love to repeat the beloved mantra that it's the gameplay of a game that matters most, and everything else is just icing on the cake. Well, for those gamers, Rage is a game that should have held up well above its competitors. Its first-person gameplay is frantic, complex, and offers tons of variety and player choices. The experience is heightened by an enemy AI that reacts rapidly to your shooting. Enemies charge at you wildly, leaping from corner to corner and swing side to side. It's the kind of aggressiveness I haven't experienced in any other shooter I've ever played. Rage is filled with many intense firefights that feel so fresh compared to the tightly scripted shooters of the modern age. When it comes to gameplay, Rage is one hell of a first-person shooter. Yet, it was quickly dismissed and forgotten by a majority of gamers after it came out. I played Rage in June 2012 on my PS3, more than 8 months after its release, and by then, its bargain bin price was close to $9. I remember dropping by GameStop around December 2011, and even early as then, I saw Rage being sold for measly $17.99. How is it that the value of this game depreciated so quickly, despite the ridiculous hype by the gaming press before its release, and despite incredibly intense gameplay? Rage being such a fun game to play, I mean, did it deserve its tragic fate? Well, I don't know if Rage deserved its fate, actually. As a gaming enthusiast, I personally think only very few games deserve to be ignored. Most games in this era end up being ignored not because they're god-awful buggy messes, I mean, they do exist, but because they're mediocre or are unoriginal. Even the games that get abysmally low Metacritic or game ranking ratings usually aren't products of complete incompetence and laziness. They're just you know, mediocre. That said, it makes a lot of sense to me why Rage received the lukewarm reception it did. Many gamers may argue that it's gameplay that matters most. But, in my opinion, when asked to back that argument with their wallets, most gamers would be hesitant to place gameplay above everything else. One of the biggest selling points about Rage was its graphics. The amount of detail present in its post-apocalyptic setting simply turned heads. A lot of attention and hype were built around the game's textures. Instead of layering textures small area by small area, that's how all other games do textures. Instead of that, the id team decided to use single connected textures to envelop large open world areas. I mean, I'm not a programmer or artist or anything like that, so I'm not sure how it actually works, but I know that's one of the major reasons why Rage can look so amazing. When Rage is running at its best, its graphics outclass all other games like it. The barren desert landscape, the metallic underground corridors, the space-age enemy headquarters tinted in blue, along with its nasty freaks and mutants, are all rendered to be orgasmic to any gamer's eyes. The key thing to note about the game's graphics, though, is that it is rarely at its best. I played this on my PS3, so the game required me to install over 8GB of data for it to perform properly. Even after that, the game struggles to run smoothly. I mean, procedural textures may have been a cool idea and concept, but because it's such a strain on the console's limited memory, what it ultimately means is that whenever I turn a different direction with the character, the textures of entire landscapes of the game's world disappear, and it takes about a second or two for the textures to pop back in and be fully rendered again. The pop-ins are so frequent and so jarring that after a short while of playing, Rage quickly loses its graphical appeal. In fact, continuing to play the game becomes a constant struggle to ignore the game's headache-inducing performance issues. This struggle becomes more and more difficult when accounting for Rage's long load times. From what I read around the internet, it seems it's not just a PS3 version of Rage in which graphics aren't something to be that excited about. The PC gaming community was left especially upset because Rage hardly offers any graphic tweaking settings that are usually present in like 99% of other PC games. Because PCs vary wildly in specs, Rage's fixed and limited graphics setting either meant a variety of performance issues for low-end, medium-end PC gamers, or an experience not that superior to the console counterparts for the high-end PC gamers. Performance issues aside, and I'm sure many other gamers would argue that even if Rage ran perfectly with short loading times, the wow factor of Rage's graphics is rather short-lived. That's because its visual design doesn't feel original at all. If this game came out before Fallout 3 or even before Borderlands, then it could have been a great cult classic. But that wasn't the case. Instead, the post-apocalyptic wasteland of Rage had gamers going, "This same shit again?" Rage is extremely disappointing when it's considered as a Borderlands slash Fallout 3 imitator. It's definitely not a fair comparison by any means, but objectivity aside, it's nearly impossible not to think of Borderlands or Fallout 3 when playing Rage. The game settings just don't feel original enough to escape the comparisons, regardless of how unfair those comparisons might be. Compared to Fallout 3, Rage's open world setting is too empty. There's hardly anything interesting to encounter in the wastelands. You can't interact with other non-playable characters like you can in an action RPG like Fallout 3. Rage goes for a more realistic take on its portrayal of the wastelands, and while it is gorgeous to look at, that means that it's devoid of personality. In contrast, the places you get to explore in Borderlands reek of personality. It's fairly common to find interesting surprises when questing around in Borderlands, and you don't get that in Rage. Finally, Rage lacks skill trees and leveling up mechanics, you know, those mechanics that RPGs like Fallout and Borderlands use to reward players. As such, progression in Rage feels kind of pointless. Completing quests is rarely rewarding. In fact, completing the game itself is unfulfilling. It's unfulfilling largely because of the weakest aspect of Rage, which is its story. Many games can be considered masterpieces even if their stories are either non-existent or just poorly written. But Rage is the type of game where story is important. The game's visuals lack personality, but that wouldn't be such a big issue if the lore behind the game's settings and characters immersed the players into the game's universe. Instead, Rage just drops you into this world without much explanation, and then has you doing fetch quests for strangers you just met for no reason, until finally the game ends with an abrupt cliffhanger. Yeah, as a game that doesn't really have a story, Rage has the nerve to end with the cliffhanger. So not only is Rage a game in which its lackluster storytelling fails to enrich the experience, it's also a game that ends so awkwardly that it leaves a negative, lasting impression. Many first-person shooters feature stories that which end unsatisfactorily, but there is something they can rely on as a saving grace: the multiplayer. Battlefield 3 is a perfect example. Its campaign was short and just had the player going through his scripted motions, but people still play that game, and people still show off their Battlefield 3 kills on YouTube. Rage's multiplayer scene, however, is racing around in weaponized buggies. I mean, I appreciate that the developers tried to do something surprising and unexpected, but honestly, this was a financially stupid decision. Gamers were expecting the grandfathers of the FPS genre to turn out an awesome shooting experience that extended to multiplayer realm. No. No one pre-ordering Rage charged their credit card to be racing buggies in a desert wasteland. If Rage had an awesome fragfest multiplayer, then all the negative things I said about Rage's single-player campaign would kind of be moot. Then Rage would have made a huge impact in the gaming world. If Rage did have that expected multiplayer and it still didn't make an impact, then there would be groups of gamers bemoaning the fact that Rage went unnoticed. It may even have won some of the Game of the Year awards. Now, at the end of the day, Rage is an incredibly fun game to play. Maybe you think that should have been enough, but I will argue that an average gamer wants more. And that, more than just gameplay. And that was something Rage wasn't able to offer. I don't want to claim that Rage deserved to be ignored or anything like that, but after some thought, it certainly makes sense to me why it didn't make such a big impact in the video game world.